Today's lecture is regarding femoral triangle and femoral hernia. Femoral triangle is a subfacial space just beneath the inguinal ligament, and it has got three boundaries. Topmost boundary is the inguinal ligament, and the lateral boundary is formed by the sartorius muscle, and the medial boundary is formed by the adductor longus muscle. The contents are femoral nerve, femoral artery, femoral vein, and femoral canal. Now, femoral canal is very important from the clinical point of view, because this can give passage to the femoral hernia, which we'll be speaking of in a minute. Now, to understand femoral canal and femoral hernia, you need to know more about the inguinal ligament and its spaces. Inguinal ligament is the lowermost boundary of the external oblique muscle. It stretches from the anterior superiliac spine and goes up to the pubic tubercle. It has got an extension medially. This is known as the lacunar ligament, and it also extends posteriorly as the pectineal ligament. This is the pectineal ligament, and this is the lacunar ligament. The lacunar ligament forms the most medial boundary of the femoral canal, which I'll tell you more in elaboration in a few minutes. So that's the inguinal ligament. But to understand the femoral hernia, I'll show you, make a small diagram. And this is show you anterior superiliac spine. This is anterior superiliac spine, giving rise to this is the inguinal ligament, and that's the pubic tubercle. Femoral triangle is over here. Subfacial triangle just beneath the inguinal ligament, formed by the sartorius and formed by the adductor longus. And it has got femoral nerve is the largest branch of the lumbar plexus, comes out in the groin and it starts dividing, giving branches to the anterior compartment, and then it also gives branches to the some subcutaneous branches to the medial part of the thigh. And it has got femoral artery, femoral vein, and femoral canal. Femoral canal, most medially is the femoral canal. The artery is lateral, and vein is intermediate, femoral canal is medial. Now this femoral artery, femoral vein, and femoral canal is bounded by a sheath, which is known as the femoral sheath. This femoral sheath is conical in shape. Let's draw it like this. That's conical in shape. It's about 3 to 4 centimeters. And sheath is formed by the fascia iliaca and transversalis fascia. Fascia iliaca coming from the iliacus muscle, transversalis fascia coming from behind the peritoneum. They form a sheet, and it extends up to the inferiorly it blends with the adventitia of the femoral artery. Just the femoral artery is over here. Femoral vein over here, and a small femoral canal. So this is bounded by a sheath, femoral sheath, and from the upper limit of the femoral sheaths goes above the inguinal ligament. That's the inguinal ligament over here. So the femoral canal, this is femoral canal, contains lymphatics. It contains lymphatics and a lymph node. It contains a lymph node, and this femoral canal has an opening above that is known as the femoral ring. This is the femoral ring. Femoral ring. Femoral ring is a very small opening. Femoral canal is about 1 to 1.5 centimeters. And this femoral canal above has got a femoral ring. This is usually blocked by extra lymphatics extraperitoneal fat. So this is extraperitoneal fat. Behind the peritoneum, transversal fascia is here. So it is usually blocked by septum. Femoral canal is blocked by a femoral septum, which contains extraperitoneal fat. Now above this is the peritoneum. Above this lining is the peritoneum, parietal peritoneum. A loop of the gut, small bowel, usually small bowel, can small. This is small bowel. Peritoneum and small bowel can enter this femoral canal, and it is a very small canal. It enters over here, and the loop traverses lower down, and then it finds its way outside in the saphenous opening. It can enlarge in the saphenous opening, and that's the loop of the gut. That's the artery coming over here. So this is known as femoral hernia. Femoral hernia is protrusion of small gut through the femoral canal, traversing the femoral ring, traversing the femoral canal, and protruding out where it gets more room, protruding out at the saphenous opening. Now this femoral ring is very, very small. It's not very wide. So the loop, when it enters, this is the loop of the gut. That's the blood vessel supplying the gut. So here is the femoral canal, very narrow part. So this can constrict the lumen of the afferent and efferent, as well as constrict the blood vessel. So there is a great chance of strangulation. Strangulation cuts off the blood supply to the gut, and the ultimate thing is the gut will become gangrenous. So that is femoral hernia. Femoral hernia, this is the inguinal ligament. This is the inguinal ligament. Femoral hernia is below the inguinal ligament and lateral. This is the site of the femoral hernia. Inguinal hernias are above and medium. That's the site of the, these are inguinal hernias, that is the femoral hernia. Femoral hernia is more common in male because the pelvis is more broader, the femoral canal is more bigger, so it's more common in female as compared to male. Thank you. I hope you understood the femoral hernia. Thank you.